Hey, what's going on YouTube? So this is going to be the first video that showcases the various classes that are available in Star Wars The Old Republic. This is going to be a video that has spoilers, so you have been warned, okay? 3, 2, 1, K. I assume if you're still here, you are interested in learning about the introduction, the first Quester 3 for the Sith Inquisitor. Now, I'm going to be doing videos for all of the male-female combinations of Inquisitor, Warrior, blah, blah, blah. But this one, we're going to start off here with the female Sith Inquisitor. So I have gone through and designed a character that I think would fit kind of the backstory we're going with here. That the Inquisitor comes with, which is, well, you'll just have to wait and find out. We're going to click play and load this up. I do apologize for the blinking, folks. Unfortunately, it's still in beta, so things like this are happening from time to time. And we have arrived at the port, which you can see. We actually need to come out here. Now, the controls are very simple. WASD moves around. Here is your hotbar down here with your abilities, your health, your force, which is kind of your mana, energy, whatever you want to call it. And you also have a couple different abilities that you start with. This is Mark of Power. This is a buff that increases your target's strength, aim, willpower, and cunning. And also internal and elemental damage reduction by 10% for 60 minutes. So I think it's really cool that they give you a buff right off the bat, so you hold Alt, cast it on yourself. You also have the equivalent of a Hearthstone. And then finally, you have Seethe. Now, this is something I want to talk about super quick, as this kind of replaces the need for, or removes the need for, food and water. Something I really like about this is basically you hit this, and your character goes into one of the various trances or whatever, depending on what your class is. In this case, since I am an Inquisitor, you come into this kind of seething state where you were just getting ready, you're letting your hatred build up for the coming battle. So the abilities you start with, Saber Strike, this is a melee attack, very simple. You do also have Shock, this is a casting ability. And finally, you have Thrash, which is a special hit. Now, one thing that I'm going to say, and I'm going to mention this in pretty much all of the class videos, is that there is no auto attack in Star Wars The Old Republic. Let me repeat that. There is no auto attack. Okay, so you don't have to worry about, you know, I'm not going to mention this or use this as a negative light, but hunters, for example, you know, in WoW, you'd always group, you know, there's always be that one hunter that just uses auto attack and fires from behind and goes AFK and eats a sandwich, blah, blah, blah. Again, I know not every hunter did that. A lot of classes do that. But you can't do that in this game. The only thing you have that's close to an auto attack is your companion's ability to use that. So this will pretty much, you'll need to use it manually. But at the same time, when you're playing, you don't really, it doesn't feel tedious at all. It's just, you'll use that ability like you would any other. And as a matter of fact, for the Inquisitor, you really won't even use it that much at all. But now that I've cleared that up, looking at the UI, we have C, opens your character. Here's your, called the Forceometer, so I've kind of referred to it during the beta. It shows your alignment. Also, here's your stats, and it does tell you the various statistical enhancement that you have. Your social rating, your valor, which is your PvP. And now when you have your companion, you will have a companion tab right here, and I will talk about companions in a later video when I actually have one. But your inventory, you press the letter I, and it shows up, very simple. And another thing is that there is no buying and selling of bags, okay? So if you want to expand your inventory module, you just click this, and for 5,000, we'll call it credits, your inventory expands. And this works out fairly well because you also have a separate tab solely for mission items. This is just super cool. You don't have to worry about having, you know, 15,000 Rancor teeth taking up, you know, your inventory along with a doohickey thingamabob for somebody's speeder bike and all those other, you know, the crap you accumulate. Plus, you have the currency tab as well. And then you also do not have access to the talent tree just yet. That is right there. You have the social window, which lets you see friends, a who list, ignoring. And of course, you can see all the players that are listed right now. And of course, if you have a guild. So that's for your guilds. Looks like it opens the same window, actually. Mission log. This is pretty neat. Your missions are all here. Shows the tasks, the class, it also has them broken down into organizational groups. So you'll have like a class quest, and then you'll have other quests for planet XYZ, and then you'll have a one for planet ABC. And then, of course, you can track it, and it does give you some information about the quest, etc. Now, there's also markers in the map that indicate where you need to go, and also the markers do indicate what exactly about the quest it is. If you're turning it in, it'll be a different icon than if it's something you would say need to pick up. Now, you also have party feature here that is grayed out. And this is something that's kind of cool, the codex. This is kind of the built-in, I don't want to call it the wiki, but it basically gives you guidance throughout the game. It tells you about various things. It's kind of like a help area slash encyclopedia for things that you run into for the Star Wars universe. And then, of course, you also have your lockouts for the different party and raid organizational structures here. 16 player, 8 player, 16 player, and this is kind of the equivalent to 10 and 25 fans. So having a lower player requirement, I think, will really help out. I know personally, having played WoW in the early days, 40 man's raids, while yes, I'm one of those people that really looked back fondly with those raids, you know, oh, they were greener, you know, greener pastures. But at the same time, actually getting down to organizing them was kind of a pain in the butt. So we've already looked at character, organization, blah, blah, blah. Here is your game menu where you have the ability to set preferences. Of course, you do have the ability to change lots of stuff, as you would expect in an MMO. The graphics are not entirely enabled yet. We don't have the ability to turn on anti-aliasing. I think they're going to add some more stuff as well. But for now, we can just go ahead and exit out of that. And I think that's pretty much everything. You have the server lag, the time, PvP, which becomes active when you reach a certain level, level 10 in this case. Zoom in and out on the minimap. You have minimap filters. And you have open the world map. Now, this is actually fairly informative, as you don't have the ability, or you don't have by default, the world map showing up here. The world map is accessible right here. You just simply click it, and then boom, you are looking at everything. You can see what is unexplored, and of course, you do have over here the legend. There's the different mission keys. You have mission area, party mission, exit, mission offer, and mission objective. So it's basically like here's the exclamation point and here's the question mark point. The kind of, you know, things you're used to play WoW. So if you I don't know what happens when you do that. If I do that again, oh, that's what that is. Okay, cool. So this is the magnifying glass that lets you turn on, surprise, a magnifying glass in your map, so you can kind of see if maybe there's a whole bunch of things clumped up together. You can use this to enhance visually the area. And so it does contain, this is one of the things that's really cool. It does contain like literally everything here in the room and adjacent rooms. So it's not like, you know, some of the other maps and other games where you're just kind of like, okay, well, here's the general area, good luck, have fun. This map is very informative, very precise. And you see here that we need to go talk to this person, Overseer Harkoon, and that's exactly what we're going to do. So without further ado, let's begin the Sith Inquisitor quest thing.
Last one to arrive is finally here. I hope you don't think you're special. It would be a shame if freedom went to your head. Or if you somehow got the idea you didn't need to pass your trials to become Sith. Lord Zash has tasked me with sorting through you refuse to find one worthy of being her apprentice, and I intend to do just that.
Now, this is the dialogue system. This is how you affect change in the conversation. And for a lot of dialogue, you'll find that there is the ability to be good or bad. For this character, I'm going to be bad. So I'm generally going to be mean, you know, not tolerating these type of little talk down scenarios, and just generally being what I would want my character to be.
Please, don't get all sentimental on us. We've only just met.
I won't. Now the rest of you gutter trash already know your trial. Get going while I bring our latecomer up to speed.
Watch your back, friend. And don't worry. It'll be all right. He can't kill us all.
I'll attack from the front, you take him from behind, and we'll see how he fares.
Yeah. Looks like you can handle yourself.
Now, slave, for your trial. There's a hermit named Spindrol who lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Spindrol's a lunatic, but Lord Zash sees him as some kind of prophet. Once you find him, he will test you.
The more challenging, the better.
But there, you know your task. Spindrol lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Don't keep Spindrol waiting, slave.
So now we have completed the first quest we've been presented with, which was to talk to that person, and we gained a new quest. Now, this is a instance area, or instance portal of sorts. You saw how we just passed through it, and we are now in a public area. Basically, what this means is that while you are in there, you are the only person experiencing that story. So it's a good way of making sure that things flow naturally. But at the same time, I'll tell you, it doesn't really get in the way. Like, you know, in phasing, like in WoW, you'll be trying to partner, you'll be, you know, playing in an area, and you'll have like 50 people in the same area, but they're all, you know, in different phases and they can't interact and it's kind of a pain. This, it really just kind of limits it to specific portions like dialogue or sometimes group quests or something like that. It's really, it flows really well. And so now we have a codex entry.
They're a special crew.
And we see here that we have an added location, Valley of the Dark Lords. And now we are under attack, so I'm going to use our ability, Thrash. And here's the auto attack right here. Now, looting is fairly simple. We simply right-click, and I have my looting set up, so that way when I right-click on a mob, it not only auto-loots, but it loots everything in the area. Now, this goes out to a pretty decent range. I want to say, I don't know exactly how far, but I think scum. It's talking. If they've stolen anything valuable, I have no idea who's talking. But, yeah, anyways, so it'll go out to, I want to say, about right here, where my mouse is right now, which is a pretty good distance, I think, for auto-looting. Now, a lot of groups in this game, or a lot of mobs, come in packs. 2, 3, 4, something like that. And so you'll generally have one piece of loot per group. You can have more, I think. I honestly don't remember. But, you know, it ends up being enough. And, of course, if there's multiple packs that you kill, and there's multiple pieces of bodies of loot, then you can pick them all up at once with the aerial looter. It's really quite nice. So our buff that we gave ourselves earlier, Mark of Power, is hanging out down here at the bottom left. And you see that we are now level 2, simply by killing these creatures around the tomb. We haven't visited a class trainer yet, that's okay, we have not run across one. We now have another codex entry, Tomb of Ajuntapal. And we'll make our way down here where we will encounter our first shared quest.
Excuse me, Acolyte. Sergeant Corman, 5th Infantry Company, Corriban Regiment. Can I talk to you?
I'm a little tied up at the moment.
Understood, sir. But I require assistance from someone who can do things I can't. You're one of the slaves Harkon brought in on the last transport, right? Here to prove yourself to the bloodthirsty overseers?
What business is that of yours?
Apologies if I offended. I thought you might appreciate the chance to not only show off for the overseers, but build some ties with the Imperial military as well. I'm here commanding a hard target mission to exterminate claw slugs in this tomb. They're horrific things. Mouths bigger than your head. I've lost 3 squads of good men fighting them. They come in packs. They'll swallow a man whole.
Death is merely the final failure of the weak.
Yes, sir. But the mission is in danger of failing. Sending more men isn't the answer. The damn claw slugs breed so fast, there's no way to wipe them out conventionally. So we started targeting their egg chambers. They went insane. We managed to get explosives to all of the egg chambers, but the claw slugs were all over us before we could detonate them.
I pretty much still don't care.
I know, but we can't do it without you. You have a tactical advantage my soldiers don't. The Force. That makes you worth a dozen normal men. Don't underestimate those claw slugs, sir. They're smarter than they look.
So you see, even though my my jerkish nature has shown through, still face quite a task before us. So here's our trainer, and you see how it does have the upside down V. And there's a plus sign. Now, when that plus sign is there, that means that you have quests, or you have abilities that you need to learn. Now, I do not have any money right now, so I cannot afford this. And that's perfectly fine. So we'll press M. And it looks like our minimap has us going over here. Notice how when I mouse over this over, it shows that there are quest objectives in this area. We need to kill 6 slugs and detonate the explosives. So, very simple task. We'll just make our way through. And there is also a chat window up here. And you see that, just put that back up there. I mean, really, for this playthrough, we don't really need to have that up there. You see people just kind of chatting away. But, for now, we have to worry about detonating the explosives, which I believe are... yes, right here. First... we'll kill this. This is the Brood Watcher. Now see how it has this little icon right here. This means that it is basically strong. It's not quite an elite, but it is a little bit more difficult to kill than some of the other mobs around. So for this, we're just going to shock it, And you see how it resisted my shock, which does have a stun component. So these strong mobs are actually resistant to said components. Alright, we'll detonate that. The explosion shouldn't actually kill us. Yep, see, there we go. It does affect the eggs. This is another thing that I like, is that what you do, like blowing up stuff, you see how it doesn't reappear very quickly, but it does affect the environment, so you can actually, you know, see what your actions have kind of results of the effect in the world. So now that we have killed 6 slugs, we quite simply need to return back upstairs while we run. Now, I want to point out another thing here. While we're moving and we have the minimap up, the full map, it does fade, and you do have the ability to right-click, move your camera around, and interact with the environment. And also, this little eyeball symbol right here alerted there are enemies nearby. Pretty straightforward, I think.
I heard the explosions when you set off the charges. Outstanding, sir.
There you go. 245 experience points. We received Dark Acolyte Boots. And we'll accept. So we'll go to our inventory. We see we have 15 credits now. We'll right-click these to put them on.
What dark secret
go here,
shall I share with
and
you?
And we have the ability to train Force Lightning. So that is a 6-second cooldown, 144 energy damage to the target over the duration of the effect. Also slows the movement speed by 50%. So here we go. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Out of range. Now, I do remember that when I made this character and got it to level 10, I did have the ability to increase the range of my spells dramatically. So just because I had to get in super close in that spell doesn't necessarily mean that's how close it is the whole game. I think I increased it to 30 meters? I think it was 30 or 35. 30. So here we have an Imperial Edict 936. Mercenaries have taken advantage of the Chloroslug infestation, stealing valuable artifacts from its depths, a situation wholly unacceptable. We'll use this. Now, most of the quests do have dialogue that goes along with it. Occasionally, you will find things like that where it's just a pad sitting around and, you know, it really wouldn't fit for... It wouldn't fit for us to, you know, have some guy come out of the middle of nowhere and, oh, hi, let me read that data pad for you, just for the effect of it. So, but by and large, most of the quests do actually have that kind of audio-visual component. Alright, so now we have cleared out 6 of the 10 tome looters. There is nothing for our quest in that room, so it looks like, judging by the minimap, we need to head somewhere in this direction. We can look at the map for further evidence of this and see that there is a giant area where these are actually present. So we can just head on through here, and we see that we have encountered a tomb looter guard. Again, he is strong. He also has a ranged weapon. Fortunately, as a ranged class, I have the ability to not really too much about that, but combine that with my melee abilities, I'm able to dispatch him quite easily. And again, we encounter another group. This one only has 2 people, and I'm using my auto attack, but look at this, a third person coming down from the ceiling, man! Who would have thought that would happen? Craziness here. Absolute craziness. Now, we are moving closer towards the artifacts, which I believe are in that room over there. And we'll just continue to kind of make good use of our different abilities. A mixture of auto attack and the others. Now, notice that my health is about 50% right now. That means I need to use that Seethe ability. Very simple. Just sit here. And again, it's based on your class, what you choose as to what effect it shows graphically, but it all does the same thing, regenerates health and force or whatever your secondary resource is. Now, this is a Sith Warrior phase. This basically just means for the Sith Warrior, this is where you would go for, well, this is the exit. This is, you don't need to go there at all right now. And this is for us. You can mouse over to get more explanation. But basically, if it's green, you're going in the right direction. So now we've entered the sacrificial chamber, and we need to speak to Spindrel. We will pick up the artifacts in just a moment or two, but for now, we need to go and basically prove ourselves according to the quest.
Slave, welcome to my humble hole. You are here for your trial, yes? Learn the ways of the Sith from a doddering old man in a tomb, and hopefully to return to your master with the mark of my approval.
Actually, I just came to get some fresh air.
Do you take me for a fool? No one comes into these tombs for the sheer pleasure of it. Not even me. No, they come for power, because they sense that these tombs hold secrets of the dark side. And they do. But before you can learn them, you must pass a trial of blood. Survive this, and I will teach you what I know.
There we go. It's like, why aren't you working yet? I'm so used to having that increased range that... Oh, can't attack you yet. You! Freeze you, or immobilize you, kill you, and now finish you off. Very simple.
Excellent. These former acolytes wanted nothing more than to earn their second chance for glory by killing you and taking your place. But your desire proved stronger, and their blood became the mantle of your victory. Well done. But you are not Sith yet. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, power. Through power, victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. This is the Sith Code. Commit it to your heart, and you will have the strength to crush your enemies. Do you understand?
There is nothing you can teach me that I don't already know, old man.
Then leave. Return to Harkon and nurture your hatred for him. And use your fear of him to grow stronger. He may raise his fist to strike, but it is Lord Zash who determines where the blow will land.
But who controls Zash, I wonder?
When you know the answer to that, you will have power over both your masters. Now, go. Leave me to my rest.
And there we have it. So just some basic guiding principles for what we're trying to do here. Now, as we move forward, we do need to locate some artifacts. Now, we'll come out of here. And I believe we go up for said artifacts. Yes, we do. Imperial Edict. So now we are in the upper level of the tome. We look around and we see the three artifacts are right there. And again, we can use the mini-map to guide us on our... or the major full-size map to guide us on our way. And it looks like we did, in fact, aggro them, but that's not a huge deal. We can easily dispatch them. Oh, but we are stunned by the brute! No matter. He is weak. Frankly, we're pretty much awesome. So the boxes, the quest items, are indicated with, you see the highlight there, kind of glowing. Makes it very easy to find said artifacts. So I'll just finish him. We'll pick up our three boxes. Hopefully one of them has some food in it, because I am quite hungry right now. And we'll be on our way. But look at this, we have aggroed the brute. And we do have about 60% hit points, but I think we should still be able to kill him. We'll just focus on using our powerful attacks, not auto-attacking. Hey, Prophet. And we need one more here, and then we can head on. This should not aggro any. So, as far as the questing system goes, it should be very familiar. The layout of the game should not take any MMO veterans or even casual MMO players by surprise. But the biggest changes are, number one, when you get into pretty much any area but this immediate zone, you'll find that a lot of the quests have optional killing components. And when I say that, I mean, it'll be like, okay, hey, you need to go disable the radar jammer or go do whatever. But if you also kill X amount of, you know, worms or whatever it is, or if you sabotage these three things, then it will give you extra XP. But it's not required for the quest. And I like that because if you're playing in a spot where you've got a lot of people around and the place is being camped, you can get in, do your thing, and get out, or you can stay and get that little bit of extra XP and, you know, grow that much faster. So I just barely managed to scoot past those guys. They have a brute, which again is strong. And another thing I like about the questing is that, yes, it does have the cinematic component to all of the questing. I find that it's really good for immersion. It makes me feel like, I'm not saying I feel like I'm a Sith Inquisitor, but, you know, that's definitely what they're trying to go for. And I think that they do a really good job of telling the story through that. And daggone it, I just keep getting backhanded by these brutes, man. This is killer. So I think it actually adds a lot. It makes me kind of think, oh, well, you know what, that quest giver at the very beginning, if it were just kind of like a standard, you know, okay, here's a bunch of text that you have to read aloud to yourself or, you know, just on a piece of paper, then I wouldn't really care. But that guy, I mean, he's a jerk. I want to kill him. I really want to kill him. And so I have the ability to, you know, convey that through subtle dialogue options, as well as, you know, just maybe getting the chance to later, I don't know. Building up to that point is certainly something that it seems like the game wants to do, as, I mean, why else would it give you all those options to, we have a quest to kill one more thing. Prove your worth. Let's see, let's go do that back down there. I've been talking so much that I completely forgot that. But yeah, this is what I'm talking about. Prove your worth. Here's a bonus to the quest. And like I said, it just does give you a little bit of extra XP, you know. It's not like, oh, well, we're going to give you a legendary item if you kill an extra two slugs. But, you know, every little bit counts. Plus, you get the XP from killing the actual mobs. But anyways, yeah, I think that it's really, I think this game has a lot of potential, and I'm really looking forward to playing it when it goes live. So we'll finish you off. And I accidentally, yeah, there we go. Boom. So if you haven't figured it out, oh, dang on it, we gotta kill him again. If you haven't figured it out already, the XP bar is down here, and if you mouse over it, works pretty much as you would expect. Tells you the amount of XP you have out of the amount that you need total for the level. And as far as fast traveling is concerned, there are mounts. There's also flight points that you would actually ride a speeder around. In the later planets, one of them lets you ferry around in a shuttle. And, of course, you do get your own spaceship, at some point in the game, / storyline. Now, you can progress through the storyline and reach this point. Like, you don't have to be a certain level to reach these milestones. You can get your spaceship at, like, you can get it at, like, level 16 or level 20 or level 22 or, you know, just wherever, whenever you decide to actually move up to that point in the story is when you'll get it. So you see, now we have left the tomb, and we are here in the giant area, Korriban Temple. Two giant statues. I love this color scheme. Let me see here, there's a couple guards, as well as a mailbox. I'll show this to you down here. So you check your email. And then if we look around, notice how on the mini-map we do have a bunch of symbols. This lets you quickly identify where the what type of shops, what type of goods these stores sell. I think each store buys everything.
I have taken care of your problem with the looters in the tomb.
Ah, then I'll assume my men are dead. Even so, you have done us a great service. Their loss is your gain, I suppose.
Are we finished?
Yes, sir.
All right, and I will go ahead and fill this out super quick. Be a good beta tester. All right, that's complete. We can head back inside now and continue with our primary quest. Well, before we do that, I want to show you one thing here super quick, and I promise we'll go in. This is a binding point. This is kind of like your inn of sorts. So when I fast travel using this down here, it will warp me to this point. And this does not look good. This is a fast travel location.
At your service, my lord.
And you see I only have two right now. You do gain additional ones, however, by discovering them. So we're going to move into the temple, turn in this quest, and then I think we'll go ahead and wrap up this video. We are currently level 3. And if you guys want me to continue with this one, I will. Otherwise, I'll just move on to another class here. I mean, we're going to be covering them all eventually anyways, so I figured now at least you guys would enjoy seeing the starter quests.
You must be one of the slave acolytes. Pretty easy to see why Overseer Harkon was horrified. Regardless, Lord Zash has made it clear that all new acolytes must learn martial skills as well as face their trials. Though why anyone thinks you can be taught is beyond me.
Watch yourself. I don't respond well to idiots with big egos.
I'm fluttering with fear. Fluttering. You will find the instructors in the Academy's archive. Hurry, and try not to embarrass your betters.
So just a simple guiding quest to send us to our objective. And this is the temple. We look around. I wish I could have that in my house. That would be so awesome. Do want. So we need to go in here. So I'm getting myself turned around for a second. Couple Dark Honor guards bowing to us. Yes. That's how it should be. And it appears we need to go in here, which is a fighting chance. What is a fighting chance? Huh. We'll take a look at that in a second. First things first, going in here. Ah, that's a trainer. This is the actual next stage of the quest. We mouse over, we see Sith Inquisitor phase. So we are going in the right area.
Ah, the last one. Always the latecomer. Now we can see what the Hermit thinks of you, Slime. Acolyte Corey, step forward, please.
Yes, Overseer.
You are a weak, pathetic rodent, and even a lunatic like Spindrawl can see this. And that means... Meet our newcomer, Fon Alt. This is real Sith strength, and he will tear you apart and crush your bones, slaves. Look on him. No connections left in the world, but pure Sith blood. This is Lord Zash's future apprentice, not filth like you.
We'll see how tough he is out in the tombs. Alone. With just me and my blade for company.
Step this way, slave. I want to speak to you privately. The rest of you, get out of here. You know your trials. You too, Fon. Spindrel awaits. Now, listen to me. Spindrel is a lunatic. His approval means nothing. You are filth, and you will die. Is that clear?
You think you scare me?
You're nothing, and don't forget it. Now, your second trial. Lord Zash has requested a special trial for you, which you will no doubt fail. Go to Inquisitor Zinn in the jails. He will fill you in on the details, and most likely hasten your demise.
Don't count on my demise, Harkon. I don't die easy.
Don't boast, slave. I don't want to see you again until you're back from the jails. That's all.
And again, this is the life of a beta tester. So I'm going to go ahead and rate this here super quick. All right, now. Report has been submitted, and this is where I shall leave us. Beside the dead body of one of our former peers, it appears that Overseer Harkoon has it out.
Your business is with Zinn in the jails, slave.
See, he is not a very friendly character at all. And frankly, I want to kill him. So, with that in mind, we're going to proceed on. If you guys want to see me continue this series, please leave a comment down below. If you want to find out about the other characters that we're going to be playing next, hey, if you want to suggest one that we can play next, if you have some experience, or if you're just curious to see what else is available, what the backstories are, etc., leave a comment. Also, if you want to be notified of future Star Wars videos, also Skyrim, Tribes Ascend, be sure to subscribe. You'll find the links at the beginning and the end of the video. And with that, we're going to go ahead and wrap this up. Again, We'll see you in the next video, and I hope you enjoyed it. And everybody say hi to Angela Raven. Hi, Angela Raven. And Bracken.